coming up next, it's a middleweight matchup between Paulo Costa and Luke Rockhold. So here he is, one of the more prolific takedown artists in the UFC at present. And when you get some praise from Daniel Cormier, when it comes to your offensive takedown game, you know you're doing something right.
And we talk about wrestlers and judo players and grapplers, but this guy just combines all of that. He is able to use foot sweeps from the grappling game. He is able to use throws from judo, and he's able to use wrestling from the wrestling game to take people down. He has an array of takedowns at his disposal, and he uses every single one of them. From the speed of the level change to the timing to the knowledge of where to go next when the guy starts to defend, he's truly, truly something special.
I don't think he can take you down, but tonight he doesn't have to. So in this matchup, prevailing wisdom is he'll be able to get this fight to the canvas. So here he is, the undefeated middleweight contender, Paulo Costa. Most would argue this is the scariest power puncher in the 185-pound division at present. And I think for those that would doubt him, he answered a lot of those naysayers in the Yoel Romero fight, outlasting that freak of a man over 15 powerful minutes back in 2019. Paulo Costa appears destined for future greatness. Obviously a big test in front of him here tonight, but he is hoping to pass with Ryan Coates. Tale of the tape for this middleweight fight. Rockhold is 6 years his senior. He is 2 inches taller. He will have a 5-inch reach advantage. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 16 wins, 5 losses. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Santa Cruz, California, Luke Rockhold. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 13 wins, 2 losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Paulo the Eraser! And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving.
The veteran Eve Loving draws the assignment here.
Ready?
All right, so here we go with the start of this fight. I'm anxious, man. What a matchup it is, and it's going to be interesting. And it's going to be interesting to see who has the upper hand early.
It's going to be difficult to find out how this plays out, right? Striker versus well-rounded fighter. Who's going to be the one that's going to control where this fight takes place?
All right, first round is underway here. We say in mixed martial arts, it's one thing to have the reach advantage. It's another thing to use it. We'll see if he can get that jab going tonight.
He has got to fight tall. He's got to stay at range, use his length to give his opponent problems, trying to bring the fight into a closer distance.
That strike blocked by Rockhold. Got the single collar tie. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, how about that? He lands a huge kick. Two minutes have expired off the round one clock here. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He's hurt real bad. That punch landed in the perfect spot.
Costa gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. And there comes the separation now. Just over 20 total strikes have now landed for Luke Rockhold. Costa gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Unable to connect with the right. Oh, that right hand is on point. G just misses with the straight left hand. Rockhold gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Gotta shore up the defense here, though. And just inches away. He could be in trouble.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He doesn't know if he's in the octagon or at his mama's house for Thanksgiving. Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Knock him out. Fight's done.
Huge connection by him there.
He needs to get on his bicycle, John. He needs to get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom.
Costa gets back up.
As he gets close, he's out of the kicking range. He'll change his stance.
Big power shot there. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
All right, round two now, ladies and gentlemen. Paulo Costa versus Luke Rockhold. And he caught the kick. We'll see what he can do with it. His opponent still stands.
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's got to be over very soon.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. Real quick leg kick.
Oh, nice. Huge shot, finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to go find that follow-up attempt. The kill shot is what they call it. Going in the fight.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. Just missing on the high kick there. 45 total strikes have now landed for Luke Rockhold. And striking at a 45% clip tonight against him.
And it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great placement on that upset.
Oh, he might be out. All right, under 3 minutes now to go in round two. That is his biggest strike as he has landed thus far tonight.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in their fight.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't see too much of a threat. This guy has to have confidence in knowing that when he extends his combinations, he's still safe, but he's also going to be able to land. He's got to be finding that confidence in his mind that all the reps in the training room are going to pay off.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Big hook.
Oh! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Knee to the body. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket. Oh, a huge block there. Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. Big elbow there, Lance.
He is going.
What a fight so far. I'm not sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. he's going to survive unless you put him completely out of there. Unfortunately, he's in there with a guy that does have that ability.
Here we go. 5 minutes remain in the fight.
He loaded up there on that high kick.
Let it go now. Well, he continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like he did in the previous round. This is a world-class display of striking here tonight.
Big punch from the clinch.
Landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count in this one. Well, we call on the fight stats here. These numbers on a... Whoa! Stuffs the takedown, no problem.
Oh, put him to sleep. Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
That's it.
He got him.
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 58 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by...